Yesterday, I tweeted at the Division game inquiring about a state of the game stream for today and received not only an answer, but confirmations for what to expect next week when Title Update 12.1 goes live. Now, I've also been doing some snooping around and investigating someone that has been doing some interesting things within the Division social community, and of course, we need to talk about what to expect for the future of this franchise. But before we begin today's video, if you haven't yet smashed that sub button for intensive Division content, please do so. And don't forget to ring the bell to receive all future upload notifications from my YouTube channel. You can also support the channel by watching the entire video, rating and sharing the video, and of course, leaving a comment. All right, let's get this one started. Everybody, it's Lieutenant Buzz Lightbeer, and as always, I hope you were all healthy and still staying safe out there. Now, one item I would like to mention and thank you all for is the fact that the channel topped the 55,000 subscriber mark sometime early this week, and I couldn't be more grateful to you as a subscriber or more optimistic about the way my content is being received. Again, thank you for the continued support. Okay, so first topic up for discussion is this tweet I put out yesterday towards the Division Game channel and members of the dev team inquiring about a state of the game stream for today, January 27th, as I wanted to prep for the event. Now, the response I received was both exciting and disappointing at the same time, but I will explain. So first, let me show you the response I received from Johan, and then we can discuss the items in his response. So now showing up on your screens are Johan's response to my tweet, and he says, "No state of the game tomorrow. TU 12.1 releases on February 2nd with the Resident Evil apparel event, a rebalance of the optimization station's cost, as well as 4K 60fps support for next-gen consoles." Now, of course, there were a billion follow-up questions directed towards him, but the particulars were all there concerning what we should expect for next Tuesday when Title Update 12.1 goes live. Number 1, Resident Evil apparel event, which I have covered here on the channel. Number 2, a rebalance of the optimization station. Again, an item I have discussed several times, focusing in on how insane the recal costs were to gain minuscule amounts of attribute gains. And number 3, the fact that 4K 60fps support for next-gen consoles is also in this patch, if you have been lucky enough to nab one of those next-gen consoles. The apparel event and 4K support are short and to the point. The optimization recal is something that we will need to wait until Monday the 1st to receive the full patch notes. Watch for that review video to show up on my channel on Monday once those patch notes go live so that we can cover those together. Now, if anything, we know that the community was generally not happy with how many resources the optimization required for such small gains. And FYI, it would be my advice to wait until Title Update 12.1 goes live before you optimize your gear, just in case the reductions are substantial. The second part of that tweet was the fact that there was to be no state of the game, which was in direct contradiction to a UB article stating that state of the game would return in late January, and I may ruffle a few feathers here, but I actually prefer that the stream stays this way. So let me explain myself. Right now, we know that Title Update 12.1 is coming. We know roughly what is in it, and that is all we really need to know. Now, what is not said in this tweet, and I guess will not be discussed on State of the Game, is the vision and future of the Division 2, especially since we know the vast majority of the dev team has been reassigned to the Star Wars project. Now, until that question is answered, with details, I actually prefer for State of the Game to not return, because if it did, we would receive the same information Johan presented in his tweet in a much longer format, and they would not be able to answer the question of the future of this franchise. After receiving that same question of the future of this franchise and receiving the same deflections from the dev team, I can foresee chat would get disillusioned and it would really start to get heated. Now, like I said a bit earlier, my viewpoints may not be in line with the mainstream. And you know what? I'm okay with that. But I prefer that we get these brief and to the point statements via Twitter or the UB forums and return live with State of the Game when they have the real detailed answers to the question of what is to become of this game. Until that time, who knows what information we will receive and the format in which it will be transmitted. Okay, switching gears away from State of the Game and Title Update 12.1 and moving on to topic number two here, and I wanted to just throw this one out there and let you decide. So, I've been seeing statements both directly from this person on Twitter and hearing this person's name used. I believe it was last in an Epic Slayers video, and this person of interest is, and I'm probably going to butcher this, UBX Shell or Shelly X. Again, sorry if I butchered your name. Now, I've been doing just a bit of light research concerning this account, and based on what I am seeing, I do not think this individual works directly for Yubi, despite the Yubi in their Twitter ID. And this would make any references or faith put in them about their insider knowledge towards upcoming content for the Division 2 also fall into doubt. So let me show you what I mean, and then you can make up your own minds. First bit is their actual Twitter profile. Notice that there is zero bio information. I mean none, other than when they joined, and they have listed Germany as their location. Now normally, a UB employee lists what studio they are currently working for along with what game they are attached to. They will also have some sort of disclaimer stating all opinions are my own. Here, let me show you what I mean, and I'm going to use Johan's bio as that example. Here it is. UB Johan, community developer at Ubisoft for the Division game. There's the studio, there's the game. Lifelong gamer, aviation enthusiast, football nerd, opinions are of me and I. Now back to UB Shell, and there is nothing. No studio, no game, no interest, absolutely nothing is listed. Okay, so the next tidbit of information are the actual followers for this UB Shell or Shelly. And in case you didn't know you could do this, all you have to do on Twitter is click on the follower's number within the bio, and it is a hot link to every single follower that person has. Now, as I scroll through UB Shell's followers, I see zero UB Studios, Ubisoft proper, or a single Ubisoft employee that has followed this account. Now, normally, you would at least see the UB employee's home studio. For instance, with Johan, you see Massive Entertainment, the official Division game account, and a whole host of current UB employees within his followers list. Again, jumping back into this UB Shelly's account, and I see none of these identifiers like I have mentioned. I see many of you as Division or UB community members, but no official studio or game follows. The third and final point of information I'd like to present are the actual posts themselves and how infrequent they are. Now, if they were truly a part of the Ubisoft team, there would not be these huge holes in their dates of action. I mean, at one point, there was a complete break in action from July to December 2020. And even when they do post, it is more that they are excited about upcoming Ubisoft titles and they use lots of emojis. There are also a large number of simple retweets, but this one tweet here really caught my attention. Check this out. Oh, the Black Tusk used flamethrower. I know that this is a bug, but I like the idea. And this wasn't a retweet or a like, this was a direct post from UB Shell themselves, and why this tweet is so off is the fact that this is not a bug. It was advertised on State of the Game that the Summit will make use of unusual fire teams and weaponry, such as Black Tusk using Cleaner's flamethrowers. Also, and I may be wrong here, but when is the last time you saw a Ubisoft employee use the word bug in a direct tweet? Not often, right? Now, I've heard them use the word on State of the Game, but UB employees usually refer to them as issues and not as a bug on a direct tweet with a movie attached that was obviously there to catch everyone's attention. So there's the materials for you to review, and I will keep my direct opinions about this person to myself and let you make up your own minds. However, there is one direct and very easy method to solve all of this confusion, and that is for UB Shell to respond to this video with a statement, including details like which studio they actually work for, their job title, and job description. Or if they want to remain private, they could even direct message me on Twitter, upon which you can expect follow-up questions as I try to determine if this individual is or is not an actual Ubisoft employee, or just someone that loves Ubisoft games and has used UB and their Twitter ID, either to show the publisher some love or to misrepresent themselves within the Twitter community. The third and final topic, and the one we're going to use to finish up this video, is the fact that we briefly need to touch on the future of the Division 2 game. And at this point, your guess is as good as mine. Sorry to be so direct, but I have nothing concrete to report. I've heard of rumors and whispers of a year 3 content drop coming from RedStorm, but as I've said in the past, I need more than just rumors to really dive into a concept. I need more than RedStorm changing their Twitter banner to the rogue symbol as a sign that we have huge changes incoming. Now, if anything, I can draw upon the previous game and reference how when RedStorm entered the scene with West Side Piers, Update 1.8, and Resistance, that the game really started to pop and take shape and became a well-rounded product. If history is to repeat itself, I, for one, am not going to complain. They did a superb job with that update, and it unveiled and incorporated some really new concepts like the dynamic spawning NPCs and the event rotations that were truly interesting. Resistance and Skirmish were well received, and the area in general was fun and intense to interact with. Now, I do have feelers out within the community to try and grab any little nugget of information concerning Year 3 and RedStorm, and when I do get something concrete to report, I will. But for the meantime, we will again be reduced to waiting for the day when all that information can be announced as we rapidly approach Year 3 for The Division 2. This is going to wrap up today's video, and if you have a specific question you want to be answered on my next Division upload, begin your comment with hashtag question, and I will choose from those that I receive and answer some of those questions on my next video. In case you haven't yet smashed that sub button for intensive Division content, please do so. And don't forget to ring the bell to never miss a future upload notification from my channel. If you liked the video, please rate it with a thumbs up, if not, with a thumbs down. Links to support my content creation outside of YouTube include Patreon and Teespring, both of those links in the video description below. I am attempting to rekindle my Twitch streams, and you can follow me over there at twitch.tv/LTBuzzLightbeer. And don't forget to follow me on Twitter for all my announcements and latest thoughts concerning most things gaming related. Until the next one, this is Lieutenant Buzz Lightbeer, signing off.